morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to the Church of St. Patrick. Today we celebrate the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Pope Francis has announced it as the first ever World Day for Grandparents and the Elderly. Our second collection is to help with the maintenance bill for our parish buildings. Kindly make sure all cell phones are turned off before we begin our liturgy. The Lady in Blue, our 2021 Catholic Kids Camp, will be a virtual or in-person Catholic experience for the kids of our parish. The dates are August 9th through August 13th. Registration deadline is August 2nd. Please see the weekly bulletin for more information. St. Patrick Parish office is open once again for in-person business. Office hours are Monday through Thursday, 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. and Friday, 8:30 a.m. to 12 noon. St. Patrick Cub Scout Pack is in need of dead leaders. Additional information is in the bulletin. Friday, August 6th, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. at the Parish Center, the swing music of the M&J Big Band, under the direction of Parish member John Shaner, returns for a night of good music and parish fellowship. Tickets are $20 and available at the parish office. Today's sign from John's Gospel, the feeding of the 5,000, shows the power of God. The boy gave 5 loaves and 2 fish. It was a small amount, but it was all he had. Jesus took the loaves and gave thanks, and God provided food for many. We too can benefit from these 3 steps. Offer what we have, give thanks, and expect God to act. We remember at this Mass Ronald Pilo, our presider's Father Rogers. Our gathering hymn is number 861, Praise the Lord, number 861. Please rise and join in the singing.
Jesus, you came to save us from our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your divine mercy is without end. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Reading from the second book of Kings. A man came from Baal Shalisha, bringing to Elisha, the man of God, 20 barley loaves made from the first fruits and fresh grain in the ear. Elisha said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elisha insisted, "Give it to the people to eat, for thus says the Lord, they shall eat, and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord. The responsorial song. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. The eyes of all look hopefully to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. The Lord is just in all his ways, and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. One body and one Spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. One God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Saw the sign he had done, they said, "This is true. one who's come into the world. Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord. Can you even imagine someone coming up to you, "We need dinner tonight for 5,000. Even with our best cooking talents, that would be quite a challenge. So I stand with the apostles on this one. Lord, it's impossible. Where are we going to get food? Jesus, in the most unexpected way, turns to a little boy. "What about these fish and these barley loaves?" And Jesus, in the most unexpected way, feeds their hunger, fills them with the bread and the fish. The apostles stand by with their mouths hanging open. How could this be? They begin to see and begin to make the connections. Well, remember, way back in olden days, how the prophets multiplied the food and gave it to the widows. We remember in olden days how Jesus, how the prophets cared for those who were sick and brought healing and food to those who were in need. But Jesus goes one step more. Not only does he feed the 5,000, but there's something in this story that's even more amazing. Jesus pauses for a while. He breaks the bread, and he gives thanks. This is what sets Jesus apart from all the others. Jesus gives thanks. The word thanks is translated Eucharist. We know the word Eucharist means thanksgiving. So for Jesus to give thanks, he's saying, "Get ready. I'm going to teach you something really important down the road. Get ready to understand what Eucharist is. It's about giving thanks to what God has brought to us in unexpected ways." The second thing that Jesus does that's different than the prophets of the old is that Jesus gathers up the leftovers. And amazing, or maybe not so amazing, there's 12 wicker baskets, one for every apostle. Those who doubted Jesus, now Jesus in abundance blesses the apostles with the leftovers. As we celebrate Eucharist today, as we move through the week ahead of us, may we anticipate God entering our lives in unexpected ways. Let us be ready to give thanks for God's presence that heals, that feeds the hungers of our soul, that enriches our life with his presence and his blessing and his grace. May we, like St. Paul, say, "That's all I need, is your grace, O Lord, your strength, your blessing, to deal with the difficulties of life, to deal with the impossible situations that come before me. May I rely on Jesus, who in an unexpected way comes into our lives to bring us his presence, his healing, his love." Let us celebrate this Eucharist, this prayer of thanks, anticipating God coming to us in unexpected ways this week.
I believe in one God, Father, Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible.
In faith, let us now turn to God, who gives us bread from heaven, and present to him our prayers and petitions.
That the church will be a constant and steadfast sign of God's kingdom in the world. Lord, in your mercy. That all government leaders throughout the world will see those whom they serve with the eyes of Christ as the common good of all humanity is served by their efforts. Lord, in your mercy. The government and public health officials will be granted wisdom and strength in their efforts as they encourage people throughout the country to receive the COVID-19 vaccine. Lord, in your mercy. That as we celebrate the Eucharist this day, the Holy Spirit will help our faith community grow in unity and love. Lord, in your mercy. In thanksgiving for all grandparents and the elderly who have guided us by their faith and love, Lord, in your mercy. That all God's people will seek justice by working for the poorest of the poor, the elderly, the disabled, and all children born and unborn. Lord, in your mercy. To those who suffer from loneliness or alienation, all who are sick, and those who have asked us to pray for them, will find comfort in Jesus, who lovingly draws near to all who seek him. Lord, in your mercy. And all who have died in the light of Christ, those who have died unremembered and unmourned, and Anne Marie Hermanavich, Paul Bryce Sr., George Smith Jr., and William Everly, may they rejoice in fellowship with the saints in glory. Lord, in your mercy. That Ronald Pilo, whom we remember in this Mass, will always share in the eternal banquet. Lord, in your mercy. For those petitions that we hold deep in our hearts, Lord, in your mercy.
God of all that is good, we give you thanks. Hear and answer these prayers and petitions we have offered to you in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives forever and ever.
Amen. Our preparation hymn is number 807, God's Holy Mountain We Ascend, number 807.
Holy Mountain, we ascend. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set your mantle over the whole world in all its wonder. To rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ. And so with all the angels, we praise you as a joyful celebration we acclaim.
Mystery of faith.
Steal.
at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until you come again. We offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now into the day of eternity, among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Alfred, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, the men and women in consecrated life, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor in our burden. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. May your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Bring also to us, when their earthly pilgrimages die, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, the holy martyrs, Saint Patrick, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you. Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you.
him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room.
Thank you.
before we depart today, before I give the final blessing today, tomorrow is July 26th, and it's the feast day of the grandparents of Jesus, Joseph and Anne. And so today, I'd like to offer a very special blessing to the grandparents and great-grandparents who are here today, asking God's special blessing upon you and your duty and your role as a loving grandparent and a loving great-grandparent. So could our grandparents and great-grandparents please stand? Bestow on Saints Joseph and Anne this grace, that of them should be born the mother of your incarnate Son. Grant the prayers of both, that we may attain the salvation you have promised to your people. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you in your role as lovers of your grandchildren and children. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now if you could all stand. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all talent, profits for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go in God's peace.
Thanks be to God.
At this time, we invite all of our children from our Assumption BBN Parish Grade School and all of our children from our prep program to come forward and drop your mass cards in the basket and then to return to your pew. Our recessional hymn is number 896. Now thank we all our Lord, number 896.